This is Goshen TV.
What would you say is your grouse with your former leader, Rotimi Amaechi?
Look, that which you are looking for, I will not give you.
What would that be?
You want me to say something about him? I said I wouldn't discuss him. Kindly respect that. I said I won't discuss him. Nothing will make me discuss him. Except they decide to discuss me. Nothing will make me discuss him. Even when they discuss me, I may still keep quiet. Not because there is anything, but because I'm mature enough to understand that the issues that we are discussing have nothing to do with Amaechi and I. It's got to do, he's planning a future. I'm planning the future. And I don't have any reason to subordinate my future to his.
Now that you've talked about his future, I know we've discussed this before, talking about his aspiration to become Nigeria's president. That's talking about his future. Do you see him as somebody who can lead this country?
I think it's premature. He's still serving as Minister of Transportation. He hasn't stepped into the ring.
No.
He needs to step into the ring. Yes. When he steps into the ring, you can ask me that question.
No, they are making that you know. They are making that you know. Do you think, and I know you've said it here, and I know it to be true that you don't lie. Do you think Amaechi has what it takes to lead Nigeria?
Well, every Nigerian born free, exposed, educated, has a right to aspire to be president of Nigeria. And so within that framework, Amaechi qualifies to aspire to be president of Nigeria.
Aspiration is different from the action, from leadership. What I'm saying is, do you think he has what it takes to lead Nigeria as president?
When he steps into the ring, when he wants to be president, ask me this question, I will answer you.
He's been governor. He's been your leader. He's been there for Rivers State. He's leading APC in Rivers State. So it's on that basis I'm asking. With the qualities you have seen in him, or the qualities you used to see in him, does he have those things that every Nigerian will want to say, okay, yes, I'm going to vote for Amaechi?
I think that this competence is subjective. Some of the times, not completely objective.
All right, let's look at it this way. Will you vote for Amaechi as president of Nigeria?
I am a member of the PDP now. I don't know. But I've said that it will be more appropriate if Amaechi we had to step into the ring and then you had to pose these questions.
Okay, you are in PDP now, so you cannot vote against your party, meaning you cannot vote for him.
I am born again now, politically.
Okay.
And I belong to the PDP. And if you notice, when we declared our position, what the PDP said was that we were returnees, we are not the campees.
Yeah.
So it still ties you to that old umbilical cord that held all of us together as members of the PDP. Now, the issue, insofar as I can say at this point in time, is that your question, very appropriate but still speculative, it becomes real in terms of my response if the Minister of Transportation were to step into the ring. Now, what my choices are, what my preferences will be, are things for the future, okay, not for
so
the present.
For now, you don't know.
Apparently, I will stick by my party.
Okay, what did you discuss? What were the discussions, the undercurrent that took place before you decided to join the PDP? I'm talking about your discussions with Wike and other PDP leaders before you decided to join.
Did I tell you I discussed with Wike?
I mean, you wouldn't just move. We know the way these things work.
Now, look. I think that what is motivating me to be part of the PDP is attention that my ethnic nation is receiving. Of course, the chair has been in the news of late. Just last week, the governor announced the construction, the contract for the award for the construction of the Chukwuchu Ibodo Road, a dualization project. And you know that that road actually should be a truncate road, because any road connecting two states is a truncate road, which means it's federal responsibility. And we are glad in Eche that the governor is not waiting for the federal government to come do the work. The governor had initially taken the first step to build that road from Igruta to Chukwuchu. Now, he's willing to extend it. Prior to that time, he had built the Odufo Umoye Apokumoye Road. So those are visible signs that we can see, because those are the takeaways that we're talking about in politics. If you go to if you're playing politics and you're interested in self, then you are in politics for business. But if these things excite you as excite me, then you're in politics for service. I am excited that Eche won't be completely cut off on account of the fact that we have no roads. Something is being done about it, and it makes me happy. It gives me hope that, yes, in the future, in the near future, perhaps possibly before this administration leaves, that there could still be other roads that could be considered by this administration. And when I was leaving, I said we have been looking for development partners. As a state people, we are looking for development partners. We didn't join politics so we could look at somebody's face. We joined politics so we could benefit from that which is in the pool. Now, if we are excluded from the sharing, then what are we doing there? It's like singing the love song in a strange land. How can we be singing the love song in a strange land? That is why. That's why where we are now.
On YouTube, Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. Goshen TV. This is The Tonic.